You can hear the Australian fans roaring as they line the track here in Albert Park. Welcome to Melbourne, and the roar from the crowd can only mean one thing. It's race day. Here we are then at the Albert Park circuit, 3.28 miles of bumpy city streets, but not a lot in the way of elevation changes. The circuit goes all the way around the lake, taking in 14 corners. Note the DRS zones into turns 1, 3 and 13. They'll offer our drivers a number of good opportunities to overtake. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, and the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Russell, Sergio Perez, and Fernando Alonso. Norris, Magnussen, Ricciardo, and Pierre Gasly. Ocon, Verstappen, Yuki Tsunoda, and Bottas. Stroll, Vettel, Guan Yu Zhou, and Mick Schumacher. Albon, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Here we go then, the formation lap is underway and the track temperature looks warm. That may or may not play into some of the team's hands in today's race. As the cars make their way back to the starting grid to form up and get ready for lights out, let's hope the race ahead today is a thrilling one that will go down as a memorable Grand Prix in the history books.
After last posting the Red Cross race back in 1990. Good work. Great pass.
They've got some kind of mechanical problem. Our head is 1.5 seconds. we're approaching the pit window, you're going to be on softs. By 17.5 seconds. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon.
Go, and that was a very nice stop. No problems. Very smooth for Verstappen.
Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. so easy. Head is 3 seconds up on you, keep pushing. Nice overtake. Okay, this is your final lap. Final lap of the race. Gap to your teammate behind is 1.6 seconds.
Milton Keynes then, after a quality performance. So Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I think we'll chalk this one up as a deft touch on the brake pedal. That's allowed them to challenge down the inside in the braking zones, and ultimately, if you do that often enough, you'll end up winning the race. It was great to watch as well, wasn't it? Forget strategy, forget tyre management. Who doesn't love a good old-fashioned scrap?
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team.